Whatever you need, anything you want done, baby, I'll do it naturally. 'Cause I'm every woman. It's all in.
It's your girl, Mama Boo. Thank you guys for tuning in. Who do I have coming up next? You gotta stay tuned, you gotta check it out. Do not forget to like, share, and subscribe. And hit the bell and the subscribe. Tell them who I'm gonna have on Intimate Talk with Mama Boo. Stay tuned. Let's see who's coming.
Matrix on the
road. Ain't never been no love in the streets. Pretty Johnny Gray, beast of the beast. Well, no, nigga, king of the streets. Back to take the throne, king of my seat. Did 10 years, back to the streets. Back on my shit, back to these beats. Flipping these tracks like a motherfucking G. Ain't no nigga out fucking with me.
Some shit won't ever change, but I won't make excuses. I hope you feel my pain. I'm bleeding in my music. Separate myself from the fame. All my friends dead like Uzi. You know I've been Tyrant. Everything been proven. Some shit won't ever change, but I won't make excuses. I hope you feel my pain. I'm bleeding in my music. Separate myself from the fame. All my friends dead like Uzi. You know I've been Tyrant. Everything been proven. Ain't never been no love in the streets. Surviving the jungle is the belly of the beast. 'Cause someone with demons, Lord, send me a priest. Or send me.
Hey, you guys, welcome back to Intimate Talk with Mama Boo. I know it's been a minute, but it's all good. So, we starting it back up. I got 2 interviews in one day, so don't be tripping about my little outfit, okay? I have to put that out there, disclaimer. So, I'm here, gotta start off with one of my original day ones, Huda John. So, we gonna get into the interview and let's get it popping. Introduce yourself.
Well, you know, what's up, people? My name Huda John, man. You know, also known as The Great. You know what I mean? Some people call me Huda John, some people call me The Great. It's all in one, though, supporting my stage name and shit. But Huda John is also my hood name, you know, so I just stuck with the same name and shit. But, yeah, man, I'm a rap artist slash entrepreneur slash father, family man, you know what I'm saying?
So good dad, let me put that in there. Good dad, I have to say that when you run across him, you got to put it out there.
Most definitely, appreciate it, man. But, you know, I'm pretty much just about, you know, the positive movements, man. You know, I done, like, in the past, as a youngster, you know, as we all did, if you from the streets, I done did a lot of shit out there, but I'm trying to turn that around and create a positive lane for myself as well as for my son and family and friends, you know, like my homegirl, Mama Boo, you know what I'm saying? She doing her thing, and I take my hat off to her, like, this was up, though. So she called me.
Thank
I showed
you.
Up, man. It's mandatory. I'm obligated to do that.
Right.
Yeah.
Because they only hear my mouth. Because I don't start.
She get on your ass, too.
So let's take them back to where you grew up, your school, so we can get an idea of where you grew up.
So shit, I grew up out the Athens district, man. You know what I'm saying? With the Mark Twain. We went to school together since elementary, man. We go, like she said, we go back.
To second
day
grade.
One, day
we got
one,
the
like,
ugly pictures.
You know what I'm saying?
Second grade, ugly pictures. We got them.
No, for real, man. You know, I bought off 131st Street between Avalon and San Pedro, man. And she right up the street. You know what I mean? So we grew up together. You know what I mean?
Right.
And shit, it's family. It's, you know, it's the soil, man.
Exactly.
And I'm about, like, you know, everybody say they hood and they gangster and all that, but it goes beyond that. You know what I'm saying? Like, this my friend. You know what I'm saying? Like, you know, just the difference between a homie and all that. Like, this my friend. You know what I mean? So, like I say, I just want to be a part of what she got going on, and she going to be a part of what I got going on, and we going to try to just move forward and just, you know, set a trend for the new generation, up-and-coming kids that's coming up out our neighborhood, but not only our neighborhood, other communities too. You know what I'm saying? Like, we just got to be that voice for these kids, man, and, you know, the young, the youth. So, that's what I'm about.
Yeah, combining the powers.
Absolutely.
Yeah, so, So, what high school?
Well, I went to, you know what? I didn't go to Centennial like the homies and homegirls went to. I went to Luzinger, right? You know, so my mom's and pops, well, pops was in the feds at the time, but he had a voice from there, you know, so, you know, they pretty much didn't want me to go to the 10. They like, man, you already started doing the gangbang thing. We kind of want to get you away from it, but really, they didn't really understand what they did, so they put me. Luzinger was more so like a Crip school, even though we had bloods there. You know, we had a lot of homies from the hood that was there, from Village Town, from West Side, from Nellis, but it was more so a Crip school. So I really had to fight them battles.
Right.
When really, if I was at Centennial, it was home with the homies, you know what I'm saying? So, but yeah, I went to Luzinger, man, all 4 years, you know, but like I say, I mean, shit, there was a lot of homies there from the hood too. So, you know, I had the love, but I also had the you know, I had to go through a little, but I made it up out of there, you know, graduated and shit, still doing my thing, but graduated and shit, unfortunately, right after high school, I went to the pen, you know, and shit.
Let me pause him. Before he went to the pen and all that, this guy was the guy pulling up in the foreign whips back in the day. Like, no, I'm so serious. Yeah. Like, yeah. In the APs, he pulling up in foreign whips, jumping out.
Nah,
like, this is the one from my era. It's more, but this is the one for sure from my era. Like, before he jumped all the way over to the pen. No, this nigga was foreign whips. Seriously, young, but, like 18, 19.
Nah, real shit.
For real.
Hey, and not to mention, I had one of the coldest bullets in the hood back then. Damn. As a young nigga. Two-tone red and gray on 17. For the young cats, 17s might sound foreign to y'all, but like right now, y'all in 28s and 30s. But in our era, in our generation, 17s was like having 30s right now. You know what I'm saying? So, yeah, man, you know, always been a hustler, man. Always been like, really, I came up with my pops, man. I'm to put something out there, I'm Lil Huda John, right? So a lot of the young kids in the generation, the young homies, they don't know me as Lil Huda, they know me as Huda, but my daddy is really Huda John. I'm Lil Huda. So I came up and learned from that dude, man, and he was actually the first nigga in the hood that ever came through in a Porsche and boats and jet skis and all that type of shit and houses on the hills and all that shit. So I just learned from him, man, and he taught me, like, not only the hustle game, but like I say, being a family man, you know what I'm saying? And embrace and help out your family, but also friends and all that, like, so that's all I ever tried to do, you know, whether it was in the streets or with this music. Like, I always tried to, like, reach out and give you my helping hand, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
Now, that's up to you if you're going to take advantage of that and roll with it, roll with the punches, but I feel like I did my part.
Right.
If I reach out to you and do what I had to do, like, and you take whatever it is after that and do you. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, you know, it's all love.
So, as far as in, say, for example, a young man listened to this or watching this or whatever, you did go to the pen and did what, 10 years?
10.
Yeah. So, what would you say to a young guy that's out there moving fast and taking these risks to be in a penitentiary?
Listen, man.
Like, a heads up to them. Like, if some of this stuff y'all don't want to do, and just before you answer that question, y'all need to take into perspective that the young people today is not the same as our young people.
Not.
Like, the morals, the ethics, the real toughness, the real street people is totally different.
Man.
So y'all may not want to go down the wrong road because y'all not built for that to begin with.
No,
and I'm not saying that as far as in all of you guys. I'm saying that as in, you know who you are. You know you really not built with that.
No, facts. So man, with Mama Boo speaking on this facts, right? You know, a lot of times, I speak on the same shit, and I used to, like, even when I was in the penitentiary, but what I did was I had to catch myself and say, you know what, let me give this a different approach, because I used to kind of come at these young dudes aggressive and like, man, y'all ain't, but instead of me doing that, I had to sit back, reevaluate, and say, you know what, let me approach them different so they can understand where I'm coming from and feel where I'm coming from, because a lot of times, it's like when you have a child, and you scold them, they don't want to hear that shit. They like, damn. But if you approach them a little different, they might be like, all
right,
let me listen to moms and pops.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So with this penitentiary shit, man, like, man, slow down. Mm-hmm. If you out here in these streets, man, and you out here doing what you do, man, it ain't like you ain't less of a man if you ain't out here doing what the next young nigga doing. You know what I'm saying? Like, be you, be a man, do your, like, you a man before anything, right? So before gang banging, before anything, before this music industry, whatever it is that you trying to do, you a man first, or you a young lady first, right? So be a man and a woman first, true to heart. Cause don't be pressured up and all that shit. A lot of people feel like they pressured up and they got it, like.
Yeah, you don't. I think the strongest ones is the ones that can stay focused on what it is they want to do.
Absolutely.
Versus monkey see, monkey do.
Absolutely.
And following the crowd, because you're really a follower. But to me, the toughest ones are the ones that still go to church, that still go to basketball practice, that still, you know, read their books at night.
No,
those are the real tough ones, because they have so much stuff coming at them in their community, but they're staying focused. It's easy to go left. That's the easiest shit in the world. Let's be clear. It's easy to go left. It's hard to stay focused.
No, real shit. You're
like, for real.
Absolutely right. And in that penitentiary lifestyle, man, like, you know, I did what I had to. Yeah, look, if you go do 10, 15, 20 years in the penitentiary and you come out and still have your integrity as a man, you that tells you a lot.
That's a lot.
Right? So I still got my name. I'm still solid. Ain't no snitch jacket on me. Ain't none of that. But I'm not glorifying that. But I'm telling you, man, when you go to the penitentiary, you got to be involved in a lot of shit, and you got to be ready for that shit, right?
And it ain't so, no calling home, running home, and you're stuck.
Ain't none of that. You can't call your mom and your pops and all that. And the only thing you can call them for is asking for some money. You might have burned your bridges on that.
Right.
You know what I mean? So just, you know, man, whatever it is that you or y'all young cats is out there doing, man, just try to do it on a positive note. I know it's a lot of, like, influences with these videos. Like, I'm in the rap industry. You know, we shoot these videos and show you the lifestyle behind the scenes. Y'all like that lifestyle and shit, but even that come with a lot. You know what I'm saying? So just stay focused, man, and be on a positive note and try to do things that's going to help you prosper and help the people around you prosper, you know, as a whole.
Exactly.
You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
That's what I'm about.
Yeah, and another thing that we kind of jumped over is you was rapping before you went to the pen. Like,
absolutely.
You had C, so let's talk about that.
Absolutely.
Like, where was you at as far as in on the rap game even before you left? Because you was, like, right there about to take off, and his ass did some shit, some bad shit. You know what I'm saying? Young guys, listen. You know what I'm saying? You be right there about to take off, and the devil come play with you and fuck your world up for a minute, put you on pause, and now you back on catch up.
Right.
So, yeah, let us know what you was doing with that.
I'm glad you spoke on that, because that's a real good point. Because, like she say, I was right there in the dough. Like, really, like, one foot in, one out. You know what I'm saying? And it's like, I was having meetings at Capitol and Universal and Interscope with the A&Rs and all that shit, man. And but I was still in the streets hustling and shit, right? So you gotta understand that rapping is it's entertainment just as well as if you're watching a movie. Somebody wrote a movie script, right? Mm-hmm. But with this rap shit, people tend to, like, you know, we got niggas that's coming up with the hood, gang banging and all that shit. So we want to still live that lifestyle and put it incorporated inside of our music, right?
Right.
With me, it wasn't that I was impersonating another dude or trying
to. We don't even know how to do that.
That's what I was doing.
We don't even know how.
Right? So, exactly, absolutely. So,
we weren't taught that fakeisms.
No, real shit. So, it's like I was still in the streets and I'm hustling and I'm doing what I'm doing, and but at the same time, I'm doing the music shit, right? So, it's like that kind of, like, I was between a rock and a hard place. I felt like, okay, well, look, I gotta still provide for family. I still gotta pay, you know, mortgages and rent and bills and all that shit, take care of kids. But at the same time, I had to sacrifice with this music shit too, right? So it's like, you either gotta, for example, I'm gonna use the homie Problem. And this is not to try to clown, this is my homie, I love him. I use him for example all the time.
Okay.
Problem to this day is a very successful artist, right? He was successful because he sacrificed. I was the one that was out in the streets taking penitentiary chances. He telling me, Huda, man, get your ass back in that studio, man, work. You know, let these young niggas, let your niggas around you do all that shit you doing, but you gotta, and I'm like, man, fuck that, nigga, I'm gonna do it myself. But look what it caused me to lose 10 years out of my life while all of my friends was being successful. They millionaires now. I'm 10 years behind.
Right.
Them dude, I come home, all of these dudes successful, they got $4-5 million in the bank. You know what I'm saying? So, but at the end of the day, I look at it like, it's a cliche when people say this, but everything happens for a reason.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
So, for whatever reason why God set me down, because sometimes I used to tell my mom this, and she couldn't understand it until I had to explain it to her. Like, I went to prison. Unfortunately, I went to prison, and Mom, I know you missed me and shit. The family missed me. My son, I lost a lot of years with my son, man, and that hurt the most. Mm-hmm. But I had to tell my mom that they might have saved me.
Yeah,
you see what I'm saying?
That's true.
Because sometimes, man, I was doing so much, man, not to really bragging and boasting, man, but not legitimate, but like in the streets, I was worth about $400,000 or $500,000. And it was a lot of dudes that probably would have wanted to take my life for that bag.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Even though I lost everything, I came home not to what I left with. I lost everything. That's another thing. Like, when you out here in these streets, man, it's all a part of it. Like, you can't go to the penitentiary and cry about what you was doing, man. I lost everything, man. But now I was at, God blessed me to have another chance to come home and have my freedom. And that's the biggest bag to me in the world. I got my freedom.
And
the chance to rebuild. I could be sitting in prison right now with $100 million. So what? What does it mean?
Right.
I can't do nothing with it.
So
at the end of the day, your freedom is more important, man. But it's crazy. It's amazing to me how shit just turns out, man. So I just like sit back and analyze since I've been home, like, just how to go at this shit to live accustomed to the way I was living at first, but on the positive note, on the legit side, right? And still be able to create lanes for people and help people out with this music shit or in the community. Like my homegirl Mama Boo, man, she do a lot of shit in the community, man. You know, giving away food and all that type of shit. Like, that shit is important. Like, we need more leaders and mentors like my homegirl, man. Right. Like, we need that.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? And that's why I say I take my hat off to her. She doing some real positive shit. So I'm with that type of shit myself. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, if I have time, you know, I do a lot of shit, but if it's the time I can pull up and be a part of what you're doing, if I got some time, then I'll pull up and do that just to show mm-hmm. face, even if it's 30, 45 minutes or an hour, yeah. just to show, you know, if it's
support.
Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Because we need shit like that, man.
Absolutely.
Most definitely.
Absolutely. So what are you working on now? Now, I see the clothing line, his son's clothing line, so I want you to talk to us about this.
Right. Yeah, so this is my son. He got a clothing brand called Gouda Gods. And for y'all that's watching right now, man, check it out. It's on Instagram. Gouda Gods. G-O-U-D-A Gods. G-O-D with the dollar sign S. Gouda Gods. Yeah, my son, man, he started his own clothing brand. This kid, I'm going to tell you something about my son. And it's a trip that he reminds me so much of myself, right?
He looked like he have your face.
He's like, yeah. Hey, this is crazy. When I was his age, he's 15, about to be 16 years old. I was already gang banging and shit, which I say I don't glorify that shit. It's
right.
what happened.
But it is what it is.
It is what it is, right?
Right.
But what I respect this kid for, man, he's 15. At that age, I was already doing what I was doing. This kid came. It was his 15th birthday. I gave him cash. A lot of people gave him Cash App and shit. We didn't have Cash App in our days.
Nah.
Everything different. You know what I'm saying? But he gained about, like, I want to say $1,200. Instead of him saying, I want to go get some Balenciagas or some, mm-hmm. you know what I'm saying, whatever's popular right now, he said, hey, Pops, you know what I want to do? I want to invest my money into my clothing brand. I want to start a club. I said, damn, this kid, are you? I say, listen, man, if that's what you want to do, I'm
Let's
behind
do
you
it.
100%.
Right.
I could, it really, like, it just made me sit back like, damn, that's my son. He's a hustler.
It made you feel good.
It made me feel good. That he's a hustler. Mm-hmm. Like, he like
but on a positive
on a positive note. You know what I'm saying? And not only did he start his clothing brand, he pushing that shit. You know what I'm saying? Like, he really like, this is not the only logo. He got about like 5 or 6 different logos. He's printing up shoes and shit. Like, he really masks and beanies and hats and shit. So, like, that's what my son is on. And he's also an athlete, though. You know,
yeah,
so
football. I just seen
he
that.
He do
yeah.
football and shit, man. He's a hell of an athlete. But right now with this pandemic, it's like this gave him some time to venture out another shit. He even said he wanted to rap before. Man, I'm like, oh, I don't know if I want him to get into the business, man. Like, but then I said, well, fuck it. I'ma let him go and venture out on that too.
Yeah.
So he been writing music lately and shit, you know, and at the same time keep pushing his clothing brand, man.
Yeah.
So yeah, that's what he on, you know, and I'm gonna push 100% behind it, you know.
Heck yeah.
Absolutely.
Heck yeah, and I'ma leave all the info down below so you guys will be able to click on it and go straight to his website or what have you, you know,
yeah,
to
yeah.
support. I mean,
yeah.
you're talking about a young man, 15 years old, already trying to do his clothing line. So support, you know what I'm saying? Let him know that the community is backing him with something positive, because it seems like we always backing the fuck niggas.
Nah,
you know
real.
What I'm saying? I don't
yeah,
know if it be
real.
Fear or whatever it be, but people back the fuck shit.
Yeah.
But real stuff is like, it's hard to get people to support you,
yeah.
but that's a whole nother book. You
yeah,
know what I mean?
Real,
because
real,
I don't even
real.
Understand it, but
yeah.
it's okay though. So what do you have coming up? What is there for us to expect of you?
Well, man, I'm working on the EP right now. You know, right now, I did, like as we spoke on, I did 10 years in prison. So the music been.
Hey, welcome back. Thanks, Doc. Please share and subscribe. And as well, leave your comments below. Let me know what you're thinking. I really appreciate the love and the support. So until next time, in the meantime or between time, I'm going to be playing out who am I going to have next up and talking about food. Thank you guys. Much love and respect.